Welcome students. Today we are going to see unit number 6, torsion. Okay. A shaft is said to be in torsion when equal and opposite torques are applied at the two ends of the shaft. The torque is equal to the product of force applied and radius of the shaft. The force is that is nothing but what tangentially to the ends of the shaft. Due to application of these torques at the two ends, the shaft is subjected to twisting moment, and because of that, the shear stresses and shear strengths in the material of the shaft is what produced. So today we are going to discuss derivation of shear stress produced in circular shaft subjected to torsion. When circular shaft is subjected to torsion, shear stresses are set up in the material of the shaft. To determine the magnitude of shear stress at any point on the shaft, consider that the shaft is fixed at one end, that is, this fixed is nothing but what A, and free at other end, that is BB, as shown in figure, this A. Let CD is any line on the outer surface of the shaft. Now this is nothing but what CD, this is what any line on the outer surface of the shaft. Now the lead shaft is subjected to torque T at the ends BB, as shown in figure. This is what torque T is applied at this end BB. Because of that, what happens as a result of this torque T, the shaft at end BB will rotate clockwise and every cross section of the shaft will be subjected to shear stresses. The point D will shift to D dash. This point D will shift to the D dash. This is what point D. So I will join this line. This is nothing but what angle phi. Okay, this point D will shift to the D dash, and hence line CD will deflect it to CD dash, as shown in figure A. Similarly, on figure this B, the line OD will shift it to OD dash. This is what OD line. This shifted to this is what OD dash. Okay. Now, suppose R is the radius of the shaft. L is equal to what length of the shaft T, that is what torque applied at the end BB. Tau, that is shear stress induced in the surface of the shaft due to torque T. Again next C, that is what modulus of rigidity, and phi, this is what angle D, angle in the what D C D dash. Again this is nothing but what theta, this angle between OD dash. Okay, now the distortion at the outer surface due to torque T, that is distortion at outer surface due to torque T. So what happens here? Distortion is equal to what? D into D dash. Okay. Therefore, shear strain at outer surface is equal to distortion per unit length is equal to next distortion at outer surface divided by length of shaft, or also say as original length. The distortion is nothing but what D dash divided by length L. Okay, therefore is equal to again D dash divided by this CD. Now shear strain at outer surface. This is nothing but what? Shear stress at outer surface. This is also known as phi. Phi is equal to dd dash divided by cd. Now see, this is what equation number 1. Now see figure B. In figure B, arc dd dash is equal to OD into theta. This OD is nothing but what? This is what? Radius into this theta. Okay. So, put this value in equation 1. Phi is equal to this divided by CD. D dash value is here. Theta. CD is nothing but what? Length L. So, this is what? Equation 3. Now, we know that shear modulus or modulus of rigidity. This is nothing but what? This is denoted by C. C is equal to shear stress induced divided by shear strain produced. This is equal to what? Shear stress. This is what? Tau. Divided by shear strain. This is what? Phi. We have the value of phi. Therefore, C is equal to this tau divided by R into theta divided by L. So, simply C is equal to this tau into L divided by R into theta. This is what? Equation. Again, we can rewrite this equation is equal to this C into theta divided by L is equal to this tau divided by R. This is what? Equation 4. This is equation that is what? Shear stress. Now, from this equation, suppose this theta, C and L is are constant, then this tau is directly proportional to what? Radius R. Suppose we can consider in figure B, suppose here is stress, small shear stress, small q is there at distance of small r. I will write here. Suppose this is what a figure. Okay. In that figure, this is O, this is D, this is what? D dash. Now next, at distance of R, this is what? Small r. Small q is there. Okay. So, the equation 4 can again rewrite as, now C theta by L is equal to what? Tau divided by R is equal to this small q divided by small r. Small q is nothing but what? Shear stress at any point of this small r. Okay. This is what? Shear stress. Derivation for shear stress in circular shaft subjected to torsion. Okay. This is up to what? Derivation. Now we are going to see another next problem. That is what? Maximum torque transmitted by circular shaft. The second point we are going to see, that is additional point is there. Maximum torque transmitted by a circular solid shaft. Okay, so formula is directly given as maximum torque T is equal to pi by 16 this tau into d cube. Okay, similarly again another formula. Simple formula is here. This is what maximum torque transmitted by circular solid shaft. So tau T, that is maximum torque, is equal to pi by 16 tau into d cube. Similarly in hollow shaft, in case of shaft, therefore T is equal to this pi by 16 this tau into bracket d outer raise to 4 d in minus d inner raise to 4 divided by d outer. This is what outer diameter, inner diameter divided by this outer diameter. This is for hollow shaft. Now next, another one formula is there. This formula is too much important, so I am going to explain here only. Okay, torque in terms of polar moment of inertia. Torques in terms of polar moment of inertia. So simply formula is there, T by J is equal to tau divided by R is equal to C theta by L. So these formulas, first is what derivation, this will be asked in examination. Again the formula of first, that is what T is equal to pi by 16 tau into D cube, another for hollow shaft, and this torque in terms of polar